morning, and it's a privilege and a honor this morning, even as we gather and to hear the word of God in these unique circumstances. This is the eighth Sunday that we have been coming live, trying to teach the word of God, and the theme that we've chosen this couple of weeks has been times, season, and response. Time, season, and response. And we began by looking at the book of Jacob, and I will not go back there. We began by looking at the book of Jacob, and we studied quite some time about some mysteries about Jacob. But last Sunday, we began a journey by looking at the first lockdown in the history of the Bible in the man by the name of Noah. And I took some time to study Genesis chapter 7, and we also concluded by going to Genesis chapter number 8. And this morning, I want to pick up back in chapter number 8, but we'll look at a few scriptures in chapter 7 so that there is a flow for us to appreciate. Three things that I want us to capture on. Number one, we want to look at what was the strategy that Noah applies? What strategy that Noah applies to emerge on the face of this earth? After being locked down for almost a whole year, what strategy that does Noah apply to emerge and emerge strong and successful? The second issue is that we'll be looking at how do we rebuild our life after the lockdown? How do you rebuild your life after the lockdown? How do you rebuild your life, your ministry, your business, your marriage? Everything around us, God has given us, and even yesterday the president, those of us in Kenya, extended another 21 days of lockdown. And God has a bigger reason. We may not feel very appreciative about it, but God has a bigger reason. So how do you rebuild your life in this time of lockdown? And number three, we'll be looking at what are the lessons that we have to learn in this lockdown. What should be our priorities? What needs to change in our lives? What new things do we need to adapt? And now I want us to go to the book of Genesis 7. We'll read one or two scriptures and then we'll focus on verse chapter 8, which is my primary focus this morning. Now, Genesis chapter 7, verse 1 and 2, we'll begin there. Then the Lord said to Noah, "Come into the ark, and you and all your household, because I have seen that you are righteous before me in all this generation." And one thing we've been emphasizing, the lockdown is requiring you to function not as one, but as a household. Let's jump to verse 11. In the 600th year of Noah's life, in the second month, on the seventh day of the month, on that day, all the fountains of the great deep were broken up, and the windows of heaven were opened, and the rain was on the earth 40 days and 40 nights. Verse 16. And so these that entered, male and female, and all flesh, went in as God commanded him, and the Lord shut him in. Now let's go to chapter 8, where we want to focus on. Then God remembered Noah. God remembered Noah and all the wild animals and the livestock that were with him in the ark. And he sent a wind over the earth, and the waters receded. Now the springs of the deep and the floodgates of the heavens had been closed, and the rain had stopped falling from the sky, and the waters receded, staying from the earth. At the end of the 440 days, the water had gone down. Verse 4. And on the 17th day of the seventh month, the ark came to rest on the mountains of Ararat. And the waters continued to recede until the tenth month. And on the first day of the tenth month, the tops of the mountain became visible. Let's go to verse 6. After 40 days, Noah opened the windows, and he had made in the ark, and he sent out a raven, and it kept flying back and forth until the water had dried up from the ark. In fact, I came to realize that the raven never came back. And then he sent out a dove to see if the water had receded from the surface of the ground. But the dove could not find no place to set its feet because there was water all over the surface of the earth. so it returned to Noah in the ark. It is only a dove that returned. And he reached out his hand and took the dove and brought it back to himself in the ark. And he waited 7 more days, and again he sent out the dove from the ark. When the dove returned to him in the evening, there was in its beak was a fleshly plant olive oil. And look at why an olive oil. An olive leaf, sorry. And Noah knew that the water had receded from the ark, and he waited 7 more days, and he sent the dove out again. But this time it never returned to him. Now I'm going to share a couple of issues that I need to emphasize from chapter number 8. The first principle that we see Noah observing, the Bible says, and God remembered Noah. Look at this, but I want to take it a bit higher. God remembered Noah. It's a very powerful statement. Now, one who asks themselves, did God forget Noah? Because the scripture begins in chapter 8 declaring, God remembered Noah. I took time to go to the Hebrew word. That Hebrew word is the word Zakar. Z-A-K-A-R. Zakar. Z-A-K-A-R. And that word means to bring someone or something to mind. To bring someone or something to mind. And when you bring, in other words, though they were in the ark, God was over them. But the time for the fulfillment of their coming out had not yet come. And so it doesn't mean God forgot, but God was looking for the right time to bring them to focus and now begin to allow them to move to the next level. So that's what that word means, that your God has put us in his focus. And even as we're in this lockdown, remember, God has put us in his focus and he's waiting to release and launch us into another phase of our life. The second thing we see about Noah, the Bible says, Noah opened the window. And there are three things that I say that I'm going to add here again. Noah opened the window. It is God who locked the ark after they had entered in. But Noah himself also did things after the rains have come to an end. And that's one thing that the church must understand. In this lockdown, don't just sit and do nothing. Three things we learn and the teachers, do something. Number one, you must do something. You must initiate things. You must reach out to your family. You must reach out to your members. You must reach out to your brothers. Even in the lockdown, Noah opened the windows. He did something. The second thing, he opened the window. That word window has suggests to us he wanted to find a new perspective. He has been locked down for almost a year. And now he wants to find a new perspective. And so he opens a window so that he can see something new. He needs to see, and in this lockdown, the challenge I give to you, please get a new perspective of your life. Get a new perception of your life. Don't just stay where you've been. Let that window of thinking change from where you are. Come through your life as it has been and begin to desire to change your results. And I say this again with a lot of respect. When the 21 days are over, we are not guaranteed the government will allow us to leave. But we pray they will allow us to go through a process of getting the schools open and life coming back tomorrow. But I want to emphasize again, we shall not come back the same way. There are companies who will suck people. There is one guy, I was reading about him, he was asking himself, he runs what is called a call center. In that call center, he has about 13 ladies that receive the calls. But during this lockdown, he reduced the staff to 3. And he's realized the 3 ladies are doing the work of 13. And so he's asking himself, will I need the other 10? And so that's a question that that will be answered by the boss himself. But we need to understand there are people who may not necessarily get their jobs back as a result of this lockdown. Another CEO was also saying, we have been using Zoom. I've been meeting my managers all over in Zoom. The question now, will I need to fly them from whatever place they are and bring them for us to meet physically? We can continue doing this in Zoom. Because change is coming. And the point You must open the window to get a new perspective for the new face that God wants to move you into. The third thing, you must receive new sight. New perspective provokes your clarity of sight. It is in the opening the window after sending the raven, sending the dove twice, that Noah understood it is now time for me to remove the roof on the ark. Because he sent the raven, it never came back. He sent the dove, it went, but came back after one day. Then again left and came back now with an olive branch, and then he sent it again, but it never came back. But that lack of coming back indicated to Noah that it is time for me to remove the roof. Now, it is very important we must hear the instructions of God. Jeremiah chapter 1, verse 11 and 12. Jeremiah 1, 11 and 12. Moreover, the word of the Lord came to me, saying, and that's my desire, that in these 21 days you hear a word from the Lord, saying, what do you see? And I say, I see a branch of an almond tree. And then the Lord said to me, you have seen well, for I am ready to perform my word. May you hear that instruction, I am ready to perform my word. Amos 7, verse 7 and 8. Amos 7, verse 7 and 8. The Bible says, then he showed me, behold, the Lord stood on a wall and made with a plumb line. With a plumb line in his hand, that the Lord said to me, Amos, what do you see? The plumb line represents the word, or is a symbol of the word. And everyone who understands the principle of the plumb line, it is used by Mesos or Fundis as we know it in Kenya. It is what they use to make sure the line is what? Is straight. And so God is coming in this time to measure if you have been obeying the word of the Lord. If you have been, remember the plumb line represents his word. It symbolizes his word. So God is using his word to measure if you have been built right, if we have been built straight. So God is going to be checking our hearts. He's going to be checking our works. He's going to be checking everything about your prayer life, how you manage your money, how you manage your tithing, how you manage your giving. He's checking to ensure, and we'll teach a message on Amos in the day to come. God is going to be checking to make sure that there is no crooked place in our lives. And may the Lord give you grace to correct any crooked place. The third thing we notice, Noah sent out a raven. And I begin to ask myself, why a raven? All of us know a raven is not exactly a very friendly animal. Rabbits eat dead things. It is not exactly, there are better animals, like better birds. You would have sent an eagle, stronger, bigger, dominant. He would have sent what other animal? He would have sent a rabbit. But for whatever reason, Noah chooses a raven. Two things about a raven, and I've said already, they eat unclean. It's an unclean bird regarded by God, and it also eats dead things. But a raven suggests a period of the flesh. It's a type of fleshly activities. Remember, Noah understood, because of the flood, millions of people on the earth had perished. Noah understood. And so, if the raven did not come back, Noah would have known there was a different thing that is taking place. But the fact that, the raven did not come back, Noah understood that there was provision and there was enough things around. The atmosphere had changed. And that's what the church, we must come to that place where we allow our flesh to die. Because when the raven goes and doesn't come back, these 21 days, may we tell the Lord, make me change my heart, make me a new person. I'm going to challenge us. Take time to look at the teachings of your pastor. Look at the notes you've been writing. Read again. Let your life be refreshed. Matthew 28, we know. It says, go to all the nations and make disciples. The church personal, my programming, my teaching is going to change after this lockdown. Because now, we are now past making members. We are past making emotional Christians. We are past excitement. We now deliberately want to start making disciples, men and women who can change the world and take the gospel to the next place. We are now going to literally change, and I challenge all of us, this is a time to go back and ensure you are a disciple. You are established, you are mature in the things of God. Because after this, the pace is going to increase, the movement is going to be drastic and faster. Now, I have been following, you know, the difference between a professional athlete and a normal athlete during a lockdown is their lifetime. The difference between a normal Christian and a disciple is their lifetime. They are Christians. Immediately lockdown came, the Bible was forgotten, prayer was forgotten, everything was forgotten. I observed and I was looking at some of these athletes. Some of the footballers, professionals, musicians, in this lockdown, they are still committed to training. I saw one of them who lives in a he lives on the third floor, and his building is 6 floors. He lives in a one-room self-contained apartment. But he is every day, wakes up, because they cannot leave the compound, he's running from the stairs, up, down, still training and keeping his physical body at its peak. Because he is not just a normal athlete, he is a professional athlete. He is not allowing the lockdown to limit him from sustaining his gifting and his calling. Please don't shut down. Number four, he sent a dove twice. The first time it went and came back. The second time it went and came back with an olive branch. Now a dove and even an olive symbolize the Holy Spirit. They symbolize the anointing. We must emerge from this lockdown more spiritual. We must emerge from this lockdown more empowered, more anointed. We must receive Acts 1:8, and you shall receive power. It is new power to go into new business, new power to develop new ideas, new power to enlarge your tent, new power to take steps of faith, new power to be refreshed, rejuvenated, to function according to God's ordained purpose for your life. And I challenge you this morning, may you receive power. Psalms 92, Psalm 92, verse 10 and 12. The Bible says, you have exalted my horn like that of a wild ox. Fine oils have been poured upon me. My eyes have seen the defeat of my adversaries. My ears have heard the rot of the wicked force. The righteous shall flourish like a palm tree. They shall grow like a cedar of Lebanon. May you flourish after this lockdown. May you grow like the cedar of Lebanon. The fifth point, and I'm almost winding up, verse 13, Genesis 8, 13. By the first day of the month, Noah's 601st year, the water dried up, and Noah then removed the covering from the ark and saw that the surface was dry. We must become stronger, more powerful. We must become more focused. Now, removing is a statement we must make. We must decide. We are not, even though we have been put in a lockdown for another 21 days, you can choose to be depressed. You can choose to complain, or you can choose to remove that act and begin to do what you need to do. Enjoy some sun. Begin to train your body. Begin to mature yourself. Because in the Bible says after that, God came and opened the ark. It is time and the ark is about to be opened. In fact, I can almost tell you, we will not necessarily finish 21 days.
because there will be a wave that will cause even Proverbs was it 12 or 21 verse 1 or 12 whatever. The Bible says that it is the heart of the king is in the hand of God. We are not depending on our president to determine where we come out. We are depending on He that is Alpha and Omega. His word is not final. The word that is final is God. It is He who can decide. The president can say 21 days, but God will say 60 days. The president can say 21 days, but God will say 10 days. What we must continue to ask God is to give us His rhema word. And nobody can stop the church from emerging. Nobody can stop you from coming back into your own. I pray that God will allow you not to necessarily, however long it will be, but please remember, you are going to come out a different person. And then God said, verse 15, and then God said to Noah, come out of the ark, you, your wife, your sons, and their wives. And so we are asking God, listen to us. We want a restoration. We want to see ourselves coming back stronger people for the glory of God. We thank and bless you in Jesus' mighty name. Father, we bless you for your people. We thank you for them that have heard the word of God this morning, that like Noah, my Lord, we shall come out ready to take the next steps of our lives. Let the realignment take place in the hearts and lives of your people. I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. The church said,
amen.
Amen.